Namaskar and welcome to In Focus. 1996 has been a roller coaster year for the Bharatiya Janata Party. The high point came in May when it formed the national government at the center, the low point in September when it lost power in Gujarat, and then again in October when it failed to win power in Uttar Pradesh. So how do senior leaders of the party regard their fortunes and what do they think lie behind them? Here to answer those questions is a former president of the party and a former home minister, Dr. Murali Manohar Joshi. Dr. Joshi, some people say that 1996 was not the best year for the party. Do you accept that?
No. It was in 1996 that Mr. Vajpayee became the Prime Minister of India, the BJP. But therefore, you see, we could demonstrate that the party came as the single largest party in Parliament and was invited to form the government. And we proved that we wanted an honest coalition and not continuing in power through dishonest means.
Dr. Joshi, in 1996, your president was charged under the Hawala scam. Your government of the center lasted 13 days. Your party in Gujarat split and the rebels came to power. And despite all your hopes and expectations, you failed to win power in Uttar Pradesh. It's a dismal year.
I don't think that the Hawala case is a case which has influenced the party in a bad sense, because everybody knows that Mr. Advani is one of the most honest politicians. And I'm pretty sure that after the judicial verdict, he will come out victorious.
In the meantime, of course, the Supreme Court has upheld the CBI charge sheet and said there is a case to answer.
No, you see, we'll find out that case. Mr. Advani has been one of those politicians who made the very first day the statement that he would resign from his parliament seat and would not contest elections till he is cleared by the judiciary.
Okay, let's talk about these events one by one. Let's begin with the forming of the national government. You formed a government, you lasted in power for 13 days. At the end of those 13 days, not one extra MP was prepared to support you than you had to begin with. To most people, it looks as if you got tempted by power, even though you knew you couldn't retain it.
No, we thought that the people's verdict will be honored by all parties. The people's verdict was they rejected Congress. They gave BJP the largest number of seats and wanted that under the leadership of BJP, the country's administration should be run through an honest coalition. We tried for it and we didn't succeed.
But in fact, you knew from the beginning you weren't going to succeed.
No, but you see, this is an era of coalitions, as people say. There was no single absolute majority party. So there would have been a coalition. Even now it is a coalition. It is a fractured coalition.
But this is surviving. Yours didn't survive. You couldn't even face a vote of confidence.
No, we thought, because we knew that in the game of numbers, we have lost. Therefore, we resigned.
Dr. Joshi, you say you tried for it and you didn't succeed. Actually, it's more than that. You didn't just try for it. You backed off all your important party policies in the hope of succeeding, and you yet failed.
No, it was not backed out. What happens is this, in a coalition, if you are not in a majority, an absolute majority, you cannot carry through all those things in the parliament. Therefore, we said, for the time being, because we are seeking an honest coalition, let us try to have a program which is acceptable to all. It is not that we have backed out from our main...
Everything you believed in, you said, I'll put to one side. No. You're there, I'll put to one side. Uniform Civil Code, I'll put to one side.
It is because for Ayodhya or for Uniform Civil Code or for Article 370, you need to have an absolute majority.
But those are central to your party. If you can't fulfill them, why form a government?
No, we form a government because we then demonstrate our capabilities to run the country and then to get an absolute majority with the help of our performance.
Did you demonstrate those capabilities in 13 days?
We tried to, but people were almost, in certain cases we did. For example, in many ministries, our work was excellent and people still remember.
Let me put something to you. Many people say that the greatest achievement of those 13 days is that Mr. Vajpayee can call himself an ex-Prime Minister and you can call yourself an ex-Home Minister.
No, because you see, for those 13 days, the country was very happy. Even if you ask people that when the debate was going on about the vote of confidence and no confidence, people were just glued to the television. And after...
Because it was a spectacle, because it was good government.
No, because after that they were expecting that people would at least respond to the very pragmatic and very practical and thoughtful program of the party. And after viewing that performance of all our opponents, now people feel that by not giving BJP a chance, a better chance, and giving them a little less number of seats, they have committed a mistake.
Toshi sir, what exactly happened in Delhi got repeated in Lucknow 4 months later. You failed to win a majority in Delhi, you failed to win a majority in Lucknow. Why?
You see, in Lucknow, I don't think that our performance has been any poor. That has been an excellent performance. With all the opposition, when all these forces were arrayed against us, we won in 175 seats. That's not a mean achievement.
Dr. Joshi, you predicted an outright victory and you failed.
The people, we take the verdict of the people. But you see, even...
The verdict of the people in Lucknow, twice running, has gone against an outright victory for the BJP.
No, it has gone. It has again proved that BJP has the single party potentiality to come to power. We had 175 seats, the largest number of seats against all odds.
Sir, potentiality ka kya fayda agar realize na ho?
Agar Pradhan Mantri 44 baar kisi state mein jaye aur sirf 4 seat jeete wahan, usko aap nahi kehte kuch?
Agar unki haar aapse bhi kharab ho, to iska to nahi na matlab you have anything to be proud of?
Iska arth ye hai ki itni koshishon ke baad wo log to sirf 4 seat hi la paaye. Hum to 175 laaye. Aur uske baad aur logon ne hamare saath khule aakar ke samarthan bhi diya.
But compared to the situation in 1991, you're continuously failing to live up to that high water mark.
No, 1991 was there, then 1993. Aap jante hain ki uske baad logon ne hamare barkhilaaf milkar puri koshish ye ki hai ki Bharatiya Janata Party ko aane na diya jaye.
Matlab saazish ki hai aapke saath.
Saazish ki hai. Uttar Pradesh mein to Rajyapal ka jo bhumika hai, wo bhi galat rahi. His role is extremely diplomatic.
Tejesh sir, ek fact to aapko manna padega. You have fought 2 elections in UP, and on both occasions you failed to win an outright majority, and on both occasions your voter turnout and your seat share has stayed roughly the same.
वो तो करीब करीब हमारे और हमारे विरोधियों के बीच में वही अनुपात.
फिर मुझे ये बताइएगा, how do you break that barrier and go back to a majority in UP?
Yeah, well, we are approaching people, we are going to people, we are streamlining our organization, and we are taking enough corrective steps within the party so that we can reach the masses and get their confidence.
Let me quote something to you. One of your colleagues has said that the time has come for the BJP to change its chal, charitra, chehra and chintan.
Well, I don't agree with this.
Why?
Because BJP's chintan is all right. There is no defect, no shortcoming, no deficiency in that. And because the character of the BJP is perfectly fine, the BJP has a distinctive character of its own. It has an old style of functioning.
Chal chehra?
Chal and chehra, I don't understand what is the actual meaning of chal and chehra. But if it means that one needs to change its appearance, I don't think that BJP has to change its look.
Aap ek tarah keh rahe hain ki Govind Acharya sahab lafz istemal kare bina matlab ke.
Ab kiske liye aapka ishara, main jo nahi kehta, lekin main khud nahi samajhta hu ki iska matlab kya hai.
Acha, mujhe ek aur cheez bataye. You clearly disagree with him. You think there's no need for any big change.
No. Changes, if there are any changes, they must be spelled out.
He's trying to provoke that, isn't he?
Nothing. In the executive, the party has discussed all these things and we found nothing.
So you found no need for change?
No, not change in this way. Changes in certain aspects, you can say the changes in certain behavioral matters.
Such as
people rushing to press without giving a careful thought. Now this is sort of a thing which harms the party that has to be carefully attended to.
You mean there's a need for discretion so that you can lick your wounds in silence?
It's not a question of that. It is a question of airing certain views which are not conducive for the growth of the party, which they should have been discussed within the party forum first.
You're saying there are too many people in the party speaking out publicly?
Some of them speak out those issues which have not been discussed or threshed out in the party.
Ye kaun hai log?
Yeah, people know them.
Nahin, mujhe nahi pata, aap batayega?
Yeah, you know them.
I don't.
Then you will know it through media and through your own efforts.
Help me, why are you hiding it from me? You're an open man.
You are a very resourceful person. You don't need anybody's help.
Okay, let me then ask you, are you thinking and talking of people like Mr. Kalyan Singh?
I'm saying I'm not talking about any individual. I'm talking about the general behavioral pattern.
Okay, let me try something else with you. One of the things that your experience in Delhi and your experience in Lucknow has proved is that if you're going to come to power at the moment, you need the support of allies. And you don't have too many political allies. That's a fact, isn't it? That's why you failed in Delhi. That's why you haven't come to power in Lucknow.
No, you see, we want to expand our base. We want to get more support from the voters. And in that process, if some parties, say like Samta, they have come to us, whether we have now an alliance with or an adjustment with Akalis, we have with Haryana Vikas Party, we have with Shiv Sena. So you don't say that we don't have allies. We have allies.
I want to pick up the thought that you've been pushing in your own party. You've been saying that the time has come for the BJP to ally with the BSP. That would have been a way of forming a government in Uttar Pradesh. Your colleagues turned down that suggestion. They were wrong, weren't they?
No, the question is that the party discussed and party decided that the BJP should stake its own claim. And I'm sure that if the governor would have called us, we would have proved our majority.
Well, that's a dubious point. Let's not go into what the governor should or shouldn't have done.
No, but that's the correct point. But that,
if your party had formed an alliance with the BSP as you had advocated, you would have been in power one way or another, wouldn't you?
No, you see, the question is not that. The question is that BSP had a different attitude. And it is BSP who had been claiming they don't need any support from anybody. So the question is not of BJP. It is a question of all other parties. Equally for all other parties.
Am I right in believing that you were more in favor of such an alliance than many of your senior colleagues?
Well, I would say that it is now the decision of the party has been to stake its own claim. And that is now
But you at least would have been prepared to stake a claim with the BSP.
Well, the entire situation will be discussed on 18th of this month when the Central Parliamentary Board meets.
So you're not saying that your position was different from that of other party leaders, are you?
Well, we have always a common decision. The party decides through consensus. And once we reach a consensus, this becomes everybody's decision.
When the Rajya Sabha seats had to be contested after the imposition of President's rule in UP, many people had speculated that there would be an alliance between the BJP and the BSP to secure at least those three critical seats. It didn't happen. Why?
Well, I don't think that there was any such very firm arrangement or firm commitment by either side that there will be a support from this to that or that to this.
To the best of my... Would you have liked such an arrangement?
Oh, well, that arrangement, I would have liked that just like the people withdrew in case of the normal seats. It could have been, the best thing would have been that each party should have put up its own candidate and one candidate each.
But you would have liked a specific alliance with the BSP.
No, I would have liked anything which would have given BJP at least one seat. Because we had one seat as a claim. So anything, any method was good enough.
It seems that not only did you fail to win the election outright, you also failed to win whatever possible combinations could have brought you to power. You lost out both ways.
No, we could go from 175 to 200. Not again achievement.
But Gaini.
Up to 200 we reached. No other party could go, could cross their own numbers without the help of the other.
But it wasn't.
It is BJP
enough.
Alone.
You still needed the more
BJP,
support.
BJP alone. But you see, we had the potentiality from 175 to 200. If you call us, we will prove from instead of 200, 213.
You know what you're saying? You're saying my consolation is that I did better than anyone else. I'm telling you, you didn't do well enough.
No, I would say we tried best and we scored.
But your best wasn't good enough.
We scored from 175 to 200, not a mean achievement.
Okay, you insist upon seeing a consolation prize in the UP situation which others don't. What about Gujarat? Your party split, you're quarreling, you lost power, the rebels came to power.
Yes, in Gujarat we lost government, no doubt about it.
Are you embarrassed by what has happened in Gujarat?
No, we have taken lessons from it.
Are you embarrassed by it?
No question of embarrassment.
Are you proud of it?
Nobody can be proud of it.
So it's an embarrassing thing?
No, it's not embarrassing. We have learned lessons. We shouldn't commit mistakes like that which we committed.
What were the mistakes?
Say we should have been more careful in selecting candidates, in taking stock of the situation. The ministry in Gujarat should have been more alert.
Who do you blame for these mistakes?
Well, there's no one single individual. Every decision was taken about Gujarat as a consensus decision.
Is there one individual more to blame than others?
No, I don't think so. But in our party, the decisions are taken almost on a consensus basis.
But you know, it's not just Gujarat. You face similar problems in Delhi, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan.
Well, in a growing party and in a party which runs the government, there are always problems like that.
No, Dr. Joshi, you are a different party. You are a united party.
We are still a different party.
But unity or discipline kaha gaya? Erode hota ja raha hai din pe din?
It's not that it is eroding. It's like this, that when an epidemic spreads, it affects even the healthiest of the person.
Okay, then let me reverse the question. Are you happy with the way this epidemic, that's your word, is being handled?
No, I would say that the way the epidemic has come and the epidemic has spread, now we are trying to have all methods to control this epidemic and to immunize the body of the party.
Are you happy with the way it's being handled?
No, we are handling it. We are.
Could you be handling it better?
No, we are. So you see, in party, every decision is taken on a consensus basis. My opinion is also reflected there, and others' opinion is also reflected there. So whatever decision we take a decision after careful considerations.
But do you need to handle it faster and quicker because the dissent continues?
That I would say, that we need a little bit more speed, a little bit more, deeper understanding and also quick action.
What is stopping all this?
Nothing is stopping.
Then why aren't you doing it faster? Why isn't there deeper action?
The party president is fully conversant with all these things and is taking appropriate actions.
But then why hasn't it happened? Why are you saying there's still a need for it?
Quick, speedy, more speed.
But this speed kyun nahi ho rahi?
Ho rahi hai. You see, this is being the speed is there, and a little bit more speeding is necessary. It is a big party, a big country, and so whatever is taken at the center percolates to the states and then to the local level. So the speed is needed there.
Dr. Joshi, you say it's a big party. Do you think the BJP has grown too big too fast?
It's not grown too big, neither too fast, but it is a big party and it is growing.
Is it learning to handle its bigness?
Yeah, the party is not only learning to handle its bigness, but it is trying to become bigger.
But is it learning to handle its bigness a little bit slowly?
No, what I say is this, that the attempts to influence the party or to spread the epidemic need a very speedy action. But the party is trying to handle its bigness in a very methodical manner.
Dr. Joshi, we have to take a commercial break at this point, but I want to continue this discussion in just a little while. Don't go away, we'll be back in just a couple of moments. Welcome back to part two of our interview with Dr. Murali Manohar Joshi. Dr. Joshi, in part one, I was talking to you about your party. I want to talk to you a little bit about yourself now. 4 years ago, when you were president of the BJP, you were denied a second term, and many of your colleagues said it was because it was said you weren't up to the job. Today, looking back on the problems the BJP has faced, and which we've just been discussing, would you say that Mr. Advani has been a better president than you would have been?
Mr. Advani has been an excellent president.
Better than you would have been?
I say he's an excellent president.
Yes, sir, woh toh main maan raha hoon, lekin main kuch aur pooch raha hoon. Would he be better than you would have been?
Yes, he's an excellent president.
Better than you would have been?
Yes, he's better than me.
Tell me something, you've had 4 years to reflect on this. Why would you say you were denied that second term?
Well, it is, as I told you, that our party always decides on the basis of a consensus. And the consensus was that Mr. Advani should become the president, and he became the president.
Did it hurt and upset you at the time?
No, why should I? Party presidentship is a job or is a responsibility which is handed over by colleagues. It was handed over by colleagues, and they thought that the next president should be Mr. Advani, and so he's there.
Let's look into the future. Your party will be choosing a new president next year.
Yeah.
The process will be beginning in a couple of months' time. Will you be a candidate for the
No,
president?
I'm not a candidate.
Is this an official declaration?
Yes, I'm declaring it to your viewers that I'm not a candidate.
Why?
Because I'm not a candidate. I'm working in my parliament and working as a PSC chairman. I have so many things at my hands, and I'm working with the party with full steam. Anybody can be president.
There are many people in your party who will be very disappointed to hear you say that.
I don't think so.
You don't believe there are people in your party who want you to be president?
No, but they will not be disappointed when they listen that I don't want to be the president. I am not a candidate.
I don't want to be intrusive, but are you saying you're not a candidate because you're scared that if you declare your hand, you're going to create opposition?
No, no, no. Because I'm not a candidate, I had never been a candidate. In our BJP, nobody is a candidate. One of the things is that we decide presidentship by a consensus.
Oh, so just in case there have been no elections. If your name is put forward by your colleagues, would you be willing to be a candidate?
Well, I know. I'm not a candidate.
Even if you were to be approached, say, by people like Mr. Advani, Mr. Vajpayee, Mr. Bhandari, and a couple of other of the senior collegiate leaders, would you still refuse?
I'm not a candidate, I said it.
Okay, but if it were offered to you without your being a candidate?
I say I'm not a candidate.
So, chahe jaise bhi offer kiya jaye, aap nahi manenge.
I am not a candidate, this is what I am saying.
I'm sorry to keep pushing this point. One of the things that people remember about Mr. V.P. Singh just before he became Prime Minister was an interview where he repeatedly said he would not be a candidate to be Prime Minister. 3 weeks later, he was Prime Minister. Is history going to repeat itself in your case?
I'm not V.P. Singh.
You will not accept the job?
I said I'm not a candidate.
Does that mean that you will not be the next president of the BJP?
I said I am not a candidate.
Why can't you then also say that means you won't be the next president?
I am not a candidate is sufficient.
Is there any way you could become president?
I am not a candidate.
Okay. Let me then ask you something quite different. I respect your answer and I accept that you are not a candidate. Do you believe that your party president, who today faces a court case in the Hawala case, should have resigned from the party presidency?
No. In fact, I didn't want him to resign even from the parliament.
In similar circumstances, Mr. Mubai resigned from the Janata Dal presidency and Mr. Rao, after a while, from the Congress presidency. Why should that not apply to Mr.
Advani voluntarily offered to resign from the parliament, which it was not needed. And Mr. Bhumai was, as you know, the circumstances in which he resigned. And Mr. Rao, the way he's being handled by his party, you know it. But Mr. Advani has a unique place in our party, and we are very confident that he will come out victorious with flying colors.
Did Mr. Advani want to resign from the presidency as well as parliament at that time?
No. He wanted to resign from the parliament, and at least I and few others desisted him, stopped him, don't do it, it's not needed. We will fight out the case. There is nothing.
But no one ever suggested that he should resign from the party presidency?
No, no.
That was never discussed?
No.
And nor was it something he offered to do?
No.
And that, you think, was the correct course of action, even though Bhumai and Narasimha Rao have done something
different? No, they have not done voluntarily things like that. You know the way they have been handled by their party and the way they are being forced to take certain courses of action. Mr. Advani Suomoto resigned from the parliament. Mr. Advani Suomoto said that he will not enter the parliament till he is cleared from the charges. This is something great.
Okay, one last question. Recently there have been calls that the BJP should perhaps jump a generation and find new leadership at a younger level. Do you support that?
No, we should have a large number of younger persons coming up, and I think that in every state we have quite a good number of young leaders coming up. And the party will ultimately be commanded by those who are now in their respective states and commanding.
Vijay Joshi Saab, but are you in favor of jumping a generation to a younger leadership?
I say the younger generation should come up. It's not a question of jumping or just putting up somebody because he's young. The question is that youthful leadership and young leadership is emerging in the party. But you have a large number of youthful general secretaries and they are doing well.
Who do you think will be the next president of the BJP in 1997?
That we will discuss when the time comes.
Do you have a favorite for the job? I know you're not a candidate, so I'm asking you now about your colleagues.
So we will discuss when the problem comes before the party. It's enough time for us.
But share your own view with me.
I would share it with my party. We don't share views on these matters outside party fora.
You look this time round like a very disciplined, loyal party person who won't break ranks on any issue.
I am always a disciplined soldier of the party.
Dr. Joshi, on that note, which is very much the testimonial of this interview, thank you very much for talking to InFocus. That's it for this week. We'll be back next week with another interviewee. But till then, goodbye.